After all this, does Bryan Kohberger actually have an alibi? Like a real alibi? Like he was somewhere else when these murders occurred? That's the question the state of Idaho asked, and the answer from the defense came in today. Welcome back. Thanks for joining me. We're going to talk about Bryan Kohberger's alibi. Due to popular demand, Petey Parrott has been banished while the gag order remains in full effect for the Kohberger case. The defense is saying plenty through the motions that they're bringing and the court filings that they're making. One of the big ones that came out today about the alibi defense. All of this gets triggered because the defense asserts that they have an alibi. What does this mean? I'm going to explain it to you the best as I can. I'm not an attorney. I work in the legal field. I have a bachelor's in criminology, a master's in policy, and I have some experience in this, but it's all my opinion. So educational and entertainment purposes only, let's get salty. We know he's asserting the alibi defense. Therefore, the state has the right to say, tell us who, what, where. Well, let's take a look at the answer Bryan provided. Mr. Kohberger stands firm on his constitutional right as well as the statutory recognition of that right. It goes on to say, it is anticipated this evidence may be offered by way of cross-examination of witnesses produced by the state, as well as calling expert witnesses. After all this, does Bryan Kohberger actually have an alibi? Like a real alibi? Like he was somewhere else when these murders occurred? So why would they gather the entire process and throw all the resources of prosecution and a courtroom at a defendant who has an obvious alibi? So the state makes a demand. The defense has to answer. Defense says, we're going to use the alibi defense. The state says, okay, if you're going to use the alibi defense, you have to disclose what your alibi is. Basically, defense is following a procedure of technically answering without answering. They've given us nothing other than that he's reserving the right. So I feel like this is a really solid decision on the part of defense. They're exploring all of the training history of the of certain police who investigated. They're going over the telemetry data when the phone was supposedly off. They're going over the expert reports that looked at the video of the Hyundai and made a determination of what year range he thought the Hyundai was in, which technically doesn't fit the Hyundai that Kohberger owned. So they're looking to attack, again, in my opinion, they're looking to poke holes in every piece of the prosecution's case, which is exactly the defense's job because it's the prosecution's job to prove their case. So technically, it makes sense for the defense to say, hey, this is part of the fifth, right? I don't have to tell you exactly what my alibi is because I'm preserving my right to silence. So he's basically giving us a placeholder and saying, maybe I'll give you an alibi later. Bryan Kohberger has a right to a speedy trial. And at this point, that trial is set to commence on October 2nd this year, 2023. But it's very, very normal for things to get delayed as new things come up. Either side might ask for more time. Bryan Kohberger is, of course, innocent until proven guilty. I want to take a moment to acknowledge and extend my prayers and thoughts to the victims in this case. Four beautiful young people who were ripped from their lives and families and friends and whole communities that are heartbroken right now. My thoughts and prayers are with all of you, and I hope that resolution and answers can come soon. If you got something out of this video, please like and subscribe, and I look forward to sharing more content with you. Stay salty and keep it interesting in the comments below.
Feel you, it's like you're in the next room at any given moment. You could reappear. Thin air, you're out there in it somewhere. If I could only get there, I could.